Hi, I'm Dr. Rasya Dixit. I am a dermatologist practicing in Bangalore from the last 18 years. The skin often gives us a lot of signs of underlying skin conditions. Among all the skin conditions which occur, we are more concerned when these lesions occur on the face. So in diabetes, what we are commonly seeing is acanthosis nigricans. We are seeing more and more individuals with a significant darkening of the skin, especially in the eyelid area, forehead area, around the mouth area and in the neck area, along with the sudden growth of skin tags, tiny growth of skin which can occur on the face, on the eyelids, on the neck, and generally in all flexural areas as well. So when we see these conditions where with a sudden pigmentation, it bothers the person more than the diabetes itself, because diabetes is hidden and you are not sharing it. But this pigmentary changes, these changes on the face and the skin, they become more prominent. How do these changes occur? They are because of a condition called insulin resistance. The insulin resistance which happens in diabetes causes the thickening of the skin as well as the pigmentation of the skin. So with the reduction of insulin resistance, which can happen with a good control of diet as well as lifestyle and medications which are being given for diabetes, you do see a significant change in the face as well. But we can address these conditions in a cosmetic concern as well, using tricoroacetic acid peels, fractional carbon dioxide laser, and skin tag removal using cautery machines or radio frequency machines. However, remember that these skin changes can come back if the sugar levels are not maintained well. To know more about treatment of diabetes face, speak to your diabetologist, endocrinologist, make sure your reports are in order, and once they are getting into the control zone, speak to your dermatologist who can help you with a cosmetic concern.